Meeting us today to help understand the traditional Hawaiian canoe are some young crew members of the Napea program.
This is Ka'ele Makule. From what we understand, this canoe was made in the late 1800s, making it around 200 years old. The hull of the Hawaiian canoe is called Ka'ele. Hulls are most commonly made out of koa. Kukui and ulu were sometimes used, but these trees were smaller than the koa and were not as durable. The hull is dug out of single log, formed a U-shape. The U-shape allows the canoe to ride higher on the ocean and flow over rough, choppy seas. U-shaped hulls do not track as well as V-shaped hulls and are harder to keep straight on course while underway. This is why drifting techniques are used to stay on course. The V-shaped hulls are easier to keep on course but tend to ride lower in the water and cut through ocean chop rather than rising over it. The V-hull can travel faster than the shape of the U-hull but carry less weight. V-shaped hulls are ideal for smooth ocean surfaces. U-shaped hulls are better suited for rough, choppy sea conditions. If you look along the bottom of this canoe, you can see it has a calabash-shaped bulge. This bulge is called the opuhua, or simply the opu. This design tends to keep the splashing water from falling into the hull and swamping it. It also allows for carrying more weight as the wider hull has more buoyancy. The round hull allows the canoe to surf better. You can see that the bow, mua, stern, hope are rounded and do not have a sharp cutting edge like many South Pacific canoes. This rounded shape allows the canoe to rise over choppy seas rather than cutting through the chop. This reduces the chance of swamping. The hull is narrower at the end, with the widest point being about 3/4 of the way to the stern or hope of the canoe, where the hull tapers to a rounded end. Again, the rounded ends tend to allow the canoe to rise up over choppy sea conditions rather than cutting through them. The open section of the hull is called the waha. The hull tends to be between 1 or 2 inches thick. This canoe is 26 feet long and weighs around 200 pounds. Most fishing canoes were between 15 and 30 feet long. Captain Cook and later Westerners described seeing larger double hull canoes being upwards of 60 feet long. Both Va'akaukai and Va'akalua canoes had the same hull design. The positioning of the seats Nohana and the Vai is critical in balancing the load of the canoe. If placed improperly, the canoe will not sit level on a sea when fully loaded. The seats and Vai were placed on protrusions carved out of the side of the canoe called pepea. The Vai is a particularly ingenious invention as this serves not only to reinforce the sides of the hull, but allows for a wider surface to lash the iaka or outrigger boom to the hull. Both the bow and the stern of the canoe were covered with carved end pieces called the kupe. The kupe were designed to keep the ocean swells and chop from pouring into the canoe. The kupe consists of various named pieces. The upturned end of both the bow, stern, kupe is called the manu. The manu is designed to break through oncoming swells, pushing the water on the side and allowing the canoe to rise up and over the coming swells of waves. Prior to the introduction of metal carving tools in the early 1800s, the kupe was made in two pieces that were fitted and lashed together. After the introduction of metal tools, the kupe began to be carved in one piece. The palekai or breakwater is always mounted on the forward kupe. This provides additional protection in preventing surging waves from pouring into the canoe hull. Sometimes the palekai is installed on the kupe hope. Up until the early 1990s, the palekai were straight pieces of wood that stood perpendicular to the waha of the canoe. In modern times, the palekai are shaped like a V so as to divert oncoming water to the side of the canoe and reduce drag. Attached to the upper rim of the canoe called the niau is a plank called the mo'o. This mo'o provides an additional freeboard for the hull but also protects the niau from wear and tear. The mo'o in pre-contact canoes were lashed to the niau with coconut sennit and could be easily replaced when worn out. In modern canoes, the mo'o is glued to the niau, and while they can be replaced, it is a major undertaking. The mo'o is uniquely Hawaiian. After the koa log was felled in the forest, the log was roughly shaped into the form of the canoe. A knob was carved at both the bow and stern end of the log onto which towing ropes were attached. The log then dragged down from the mountain to the shore where the canoe was finished. The front knob was cut off, but the back knob called the maku'u was shaved down to a point. The ka'ele once shaved down to a point, the maku'u became the mua'mua. The mua'mua is where the guardian spirit of the canoe rode when the canoe set out to sea. There is no Hawaiian term equivalent to outrigger. The components for the outrigger were referred to by their proper names. The booms are called iako and the outrigger float is called the ama. The iako, especially for a single-hull canoe, were almost always made out of hau. Hau is a type of hibiscus that was brought to Hawaii by the Polynesian settlers. The iako are placed over the wai and then lashed down to the wai through the puka iako, holes drilled through the mo'o. Traditionally, the iako always extends off of the left side of the canoe. We don't know why, that is just the way it is. Lashing the iako to the wai helps disperse the torque forces that are exerted to the iako when hit by swells or waves throughout the hull of the canoe, rather than confining all that force to the puka iako only in the mo'o. Hau wood dries very light but is extremely strong. Hau grows in large tangled groves and is naturally very curvy. The trick is in getting a good iako is to find a log that has the right curve to it. The most desired iako has a slight rise as it extends beyond the hole of the canoe and then arches down to where it meets the ama or outrigger float. Hawaii is the only place in the Pacific where both forward and back iako are directly tied to the ama. All other Pacific canoes have an indirect attachment using small sticks to attach either one or both iako to the ama. This direct attachment is in response to rough ocean conditions that surround the Hawaiian Islands. A good upside to this is that you do not need to worry about any spindle or stick breaking off and detaching your outrigger float ama. The Hawaiian ama is distinctive in two ways. The first is that the Hawaiian ama is moderately curved, allowing both the fore end called the lupe and the stern end called the kanaka to rise up out of the water. This rise keeps the front end and the rear end of the ama out of the water while underway and reduces drag, again designed for rough sea conditions. The second unique feature is the lupe. The front end of the ama was shaved into kind cut water where the leading cutting edge of the lupe would slice through the coming swells. Traditionally, the ama is made out of hau or wiliwili. Wiliwili is a native tree that, when dry, becomes very light. It acts and feels almost like balsa wood. The shape of the traditional Hawaiian sail is very distinctive. The Hawaiian sail is categorized by anthropologists as being a crab claw, oceanic spirit sail. The sail is triangular, but unlike Western sails, the apex of the triangle down at the foot of the mast. This allows the sail to be shifted from side to side while under sail without hitting the passengers on the canoe in the head. The top of the sail has a U-shape to it. The U-shape acts as kind of a safety valve, allowing excess wind to spill out over the top of the sail and reduce the chances of capsizing. The U also lowers the driving pocket of the sail, also reducing the chances of capsizing. The traditional sail was made out of leaves of the hala tree, pandanus, and consisted of mats that were sewn together to create the sail. Mahalo no ko ho'olohe ana mai ke aha'i o lelo, ahui ho.